In the closing years of the Sengoku era, Japan was consumed by a perpetual conflict. The fires of war raged on, spreading deep into the mountains, to the land of Ashima.
What's the matter, Stray? Nothing left to lose? Well, would you look at that? Fascinating. Will you join me, starving wolf?
On that day, a young cub was taken from the battlefield. He trained relentlessly, and indeed, went on to become a master shinobi.
Listen, wolf. You must never forget the Shinobi Code. As your father, my word is absolute. Your master's is a close second. As of today, he is your master. Defend him with your life. If he is taken, bring him back at any cost. You understand me, don't you, Wolf?
Some 20 years after Ishin's coup, the Ashina clan was on the brink of collapse. And the shinobi, known as Wolf, had lost everything. Both the man who took him in and the boy he had sworn to protect.
Shinobi, open your eyes. For the sake of your master.
Thank you. That shinobi at the bottom of the well. We didn't shackle him, restrain him, nothing. That doesn't worry anybody?
Not at all. Not only is he unarmed, he has completely lost his will to live. Nothing but a coward. Unworthy of our concern.
The moonlight shines strongly on the Moonview Tower tonight. The Divine Heir is probably using the light for his reading again.
Probably, but imprisoning a mere child. I feel sorry for the boy.
Agreed. But I'm sure Lord Genichiro has his reasons. The Moonview Tower door. You check that it's locked, right?
It's certainly locked, but nobody fixed that hole in the wall.
That? Don't worry about it. The hole faces the edge of a cliff. No one could pass through it.
You did well to come here. It's been too long, Wolf.
I've come to free you, my lord.
Well then? Raise your head. Kusabimaru, your sword. My shinobi. In accordance with the bond of Lord and Retainer, you will pledge your life in my service.
As you command.
Loyal Wolf, I see you are wounded. I have something that may help. It is a special gourd of medicinal waters. Use it to heal your wounds.
My lord.
Now then, were you gravely injured? Afterward?
After what?
Do you not remember that night?
I do not.
No. We'll talk about it later. Right now, we must escape Ashina Castle.
As you say.
There's a secret passage beneath the moat bridge that will take us out of the castle. Lord Ishin told me about it once. I ask you to find that secret passage. Once you find it, signal me with a reed whistle. You know, like you used to long ago. I will join you as soon as I hear it. Wolf, do not push yourself too far. You must heal your wounds.
Ooh!
You know that secret passage at the bottom of the moat? Under the bridge? We just got orders to guard it.
Security's getting tight. War will be upon us very soon.
Wolf, you found it. Now, let us leave this place.
Yes, my lord.
To think that this is the only way, to run from the fated bloodline is the only answer. Where shall we go once we're away from the castle? I suppose the first thing we should do is cross the Ashina border. Or perhaps we should hide somewhere. What do you think?
Whatever you desire.
Whatever I desire? That's the wolf I know.
My lord.
Oh, nothing. I was just reminiscing. Onward, then.
The Divine Heir. Last we stood together was your uncle's funeral.
Lord Genichiro.
This to me. So the noble shinobi stands in our way. You face Genichiro Akira. Thank you.
Shinobi'd know the difference between honor and victory. The divine heir is coming with me.
So, you're awake. Looks like death is not your fate, just yet. What do you call yourself? Your eyes. The eyes of a wolf who has failed in his duties. Or so it seems to me.
That is not your concern.
Spoken like a true shinobi. I must carve the Buddha. You do what you will.
Why am I here?
All I did was drag you here. Didn't even know if I was dragging a corpse. Couldn't let you get eaten by a pack of wild dogs.
How long was I asleep?
Some time has passed since I found you.
I see.
However, your master yet lives. He's being held prisoner in Ashina Castle. They will soon make use of his bloodline. Looking at you, I'm sure you appreciate the value it has.
My left arm. What did you do to me?
That is what I call the shinobi prosthetic. A fitting fang for a one-armed wolf. Useless when it comes to carving Buddha, though. You can have it.
Shinobi prosthetic?
It is no mere replacement for your lost arm. Come to me if you find any shinobi tools.
Shinobi tools? I see. For this device.
You catch on quick. If you bring me shinobi tools, I'll find a way to fit them to the shinobi prosthetic. Then you'll come to appreciate its worth. I've said too much. Go now.
What did you mean when you said they'll make use of his bloodline?
I don't know much about him, except the dragon's heritage. There's a special kind of blood by that name, and that blood runs through your master's veins.
So the divine heir?
Someone's after him. might be that the strange things happening to your body have something to do with that. Some time has passed since I found you. Your master, you're quite the strange one, yet other peculiar visitors have come to this temple. There's one in the clearing to the right of the gate leading off the temple grounds. Two strangers in strange circumstances. You two might get along.
Never seen you before.
Your name?
Won't tell me.
But you do have the look of a skilled shinobi. A shinobi.
Or perhaps... Sir, please heed my humble request. Face me in battle. Still alive. That swordsmanship, it was a thing to behold. Few have managed to kill me in such a thorough manner.
What are you?
Some call it undying. Others, infested. I can't die, so I just am. How about you? What brings you to a rundown temple like this? Seems you have a lot on your mind. Say, why don't you use me for some sword practice? Might come in handy for whatever your mission is. A warm body that can't die might prove useful to you. I volunteer mine. Well?
Very well.
Right then. Let's go. They say, swinging one sword is a cure for boredom. In that case... I stand as your opponent. Again. Again. Case, I stand as your opponent. Face me again. Face me again. Excellent. I expected no less of you.
that case, I stand as your opponent. Face me again. Face me again. About our training. I think it's about time we tried something closer to a real fight. Don't you? Come at me with the intent to kill. No better way to prepare for the real thing. What's wrong?
Why do you go to such lengths?
Half to pass the time, and the other half. Well, I want to loosen that furrowed brow of yours. All right. Enough talk. Let's begin. Now, let's begin.
Yes.
Face me again. This temple attracts those with nowhere else to go. I certainly fit that description. And I suppose that's why interesting things make their way into the offering box from time to time. Come back whenever you like. If you have techniques to try out, I'm at your disposal.
Thank you.